Aeroplanes are presently the fastest mode of transport for humans. But soon, this picture is going to change. Yes, get ready for the addition of one more mode of transport in your textbooks, and that is Hyperloop. But what is a Hyperloop? How does it work? Will it change the way we travel? When will it be available? Know it all in this video. From walking on foot to riding animals, bullock carts to boats, steam engines to automobiles, ships to aeroplanes, we have come a long way. And now it's time for Hyperloop. Elon Musk in 2012 suggested the Hyperloop as a new form of transportation, one that would be faster than a plane and totally solar powered. And in 2013, he gave a 57-page outline of the Hyperloop's technical details and how the system would work. He also kept it open for everyone. Soon after Musk's paper hit the internet, several companies came up and a few took it very seriously. One of them is Virgin Hyperloop One. But what is this Hyperloop? A Hyperloop is a sealed tube through which pods travel and can transport passengers or goods from one place to another. It is supposed to be faster than any other mode of transport, and it can cover a 3-hour journey in just 30 minutes. What makes Hyperloop so cool? There are two enemies of speed. One is air resistance and second is friction. Hyperloop is all about removing these two things which can slow down vehicles. When an aircraft flies at a high altitude, it faces very less air resistance because the air is very thin there, and hence the aircraft is able to travel fast. But the air resistance on the surface is high, and to overcome that, the tube comes in. The tube encloses the space through which the pods move, and these tubes will have very low air pressure, which will be equivalent to the pressure aircrafts experience when flying above 150,000 feet. With reduced air resistance, the pods can travel at a high speed. The second problem is the friction. To tackle that, Elon Musk suggested using pods which float. And if they will be floating, then there will not be a problem of friction. This could be attained using magnetic levitation or air bearings. Magnetic levitation is a method used in bullet trains in which magnets are used to keep the train floating, and hence this reduces friction. Hyperloop capsules in Musk's model float above the tube surface on a set of 28 air bearing skis. This would make the pod float just above the tracks, similar to an air hockey game. And so, like a cruising airplane, a Hyperloop needs only a little bit of energy to maintain the pod speed. More speed with less power gets you to where you're going faster, greener, and depending on energy cost, maybe cheaper too. These pods will get their velocity from an external linear electric motor. And under Musk's model, the Hyperloop would be powered by solar panels placed on the top of the tube, which would allow the system to generate more energy than it needs to run. The time to take a ride in a Hyperloop is a bit far from now, but recently a test of Hyperloop was conducted for the first time with human passengers, and it was done successfully. If everything goes as planned, then Hyperloop can revolutionize the way we travel.